defensive corner, gentlemen.
Referee Thomas Taylor, 13 years pro experience, working his 523rd pro bout. Gave us Garcia capable of producing enough power to light up the Sin City Strip. They have up to 36 minutes to ace their moment of truth.
Landed in the first 3 minutes.
And it's
turns off Garcia, the first one to try to land power punches and doing it there. And Garcia putting the pressure on Davis. Landing the right and left. Davis trying to hold on. The buzzbeater Garcia. And of course, mixed fan base here with every punch that's thrown, whether it lands or not. You will hear from the respective fan bases.
This is exactly what Ryan Garcia has to do. Start off fast and make Tank Davis feel uncomfortable, and he's doing that right now.
Davis utilizing lateral movement along the ropes.
Now, one thing Garcia is good at is cutting off the ring, and he's doing that fairly well. Boy, a lot of overlaps.
Davis lunging at Garcia. Referee, Taylor admonishing Davis for doing so.
Warning to both fighters. A more aggressive second round for Garcia. And of course, he would like to make something, as Abbott said, dramatic happen, but do it in a way where he doesn't put himself in harm's way.
And you look at all the pundits, all the scouts everywhere online, they say that Garcia had to take advantage of Davis' slow starts, whether delivered or not. And here in round two, he put on the pressure on Davis. Davis wanting to turn this into a wrestling match.
Yeah, Davis has to be careful. Looking at the referee, you gotta protect yourselves at all times.
And he's just ducked underneath that left hook like a combo. What a shot! What a missile strike by Davis! And just like that, Javonte Davis blocks Ryan Garcia for the second time in his career here in the second. And just like that, Garcia bounces back.
Only if
tendency to pull straight back in a linear position. And Ken at times exposes his chin doing so.
Yeah, he pulls straight back like he's doing right now. You don't want to do that. Davis is my time then.
There's that hunt to the body by Garcia.
Yeah, Garcia knocked Luke Campbell out with that. He would like to get that left hook in, but has to be careful because, again, being concerned about the counter.
Same time, Davis looking to find the lead right hook there. Flex the jab. And again, tags Garcia.
Yeah, he didn't overcommit it. He fainted. He didn't see anything. He didn't take it. And then he took it because he's high. So that's how you do it.
There's a left hook check hook by Garcia. Coming up on the final 30 seconds of the third. Davis putting on the pressure.
You know, jabs are not going to be a factor in terms of landing punches. They only land, I think, 24 punches they land around these guys are jabs. But the jabs will help them set up the power punches.
Garcia backing himself in the corner, fires off the right hand, goes for the hook, and then moves to his left. There's a straight right by Garcia. Good round for Gervonta Davis.
Getting the left hand in again as Garcia came in. That was a lead left. And you see Garcia kind of looking to hang on early. He wanted to make sure I got that good punch in. I don't want to get hit on the inside. Again, to look at it, that's pretty good that he can land that lead. lead left without having to do anything else before that.
And it's almost like beating him, beating Ryan to the punch.
Yeah.
Kind of says that Ryan was going to let go of the right hand, and boom, Tank Davis beating with that left.
Manny Pacquiao, only 8th division champion in boxing history, has been involved in so many super fights, including the biggest pay-per-view event of all time. Again, that man, Floyd Mayweather Jr. Who isn't at the fight tonight? Round number 5. Intriguing things about this fight, while Tank Davis has been very economical with his punches, you can make a strong case, other than round one, he could be winning these other rounds. Yeah. And so, even though he hasn't been super voluminous punches, he's landing a significant punch.
I agree. I think he may have lost round one, but I see him winning every round, so
that's very possible.
Yeah, the clear punches definitely have been landed by Davis, and he's doing a really, really good job of boxing right now. This is boxing. Look at the angles. Look at he's placing his foot where he wants to. Let go of his hands when he needs to.
He's a power-punching counter-puncher, Andrew.
Yes, he's counter-punching really well. Garcia, he's pressuring, but he's not letting go of the jab. He's got to jab a little bit more.
And, of course, if you're Ryan Garcia, you still believe that you can turn this, even though you might be losing some rounds, that your power can make a difference in this fight. And he's going to keep trying to make that happen.
You wonder if Davis trying to set a trap there, has himself again in the corner, but fainting. And he told us that his accuracy is the key to his power, hitting the bullseye. And he told us that he was going to knock out Ryan Garcia in the 7th or 8th round.
Garcia has not been jabbing as much the last couple rounds, and that will help him if he doesn't want to have the potential of getting that right hand.
Well, he's being countered with that jab, so he's got to start double jabbing. He's got to be quicker with the jab as well, so that's why he's not constant with the jab. But Davis doing a good job of counterpunching the longer reach, the taller guy, and Garcia.
Garcia, not so much, and here is Davis. He will try to go downstairs. There he is, partially blocked, but there he goes with the right hook that does get in as Garcia is trying to cover up defensively. Garcia is more of a body puncher, or that Davis is more of a body puncher than Garcia. But Glover,
in Las Vegas, Mark Wahlberg, who was in the fighter, of course. And man, you talk about fighters. Toner, Gotti, Mickey Ward, those battles. Good to see Mark Wahlberg in attendance. And is that Mario Lopez right beside me?
I believe it is.
You know, I miss that smile.
Our good friend.
Round number 6. Davis utilizing the real estate, utilizing his footwork, trying to lure Ryan Garcia into a potential counter scenario. Garcia attacking the body with the jab. Doesn't follow up with the right, however.
Yeah, the pressure's there for Garcia, but the output not so much. He's got to start letting go of the hands, keep Davis busy with them.
You know, this 2 month layoff is the shortest Davis has had between fights since 2017. I've been wondering, would that be good for him or bad for him, or to keep him sharp? So far, things are working out very well for him. Remember, he followed there's a right hand that caught Davis, another right hand that Garcia with his best moments of the fight. Remember, Davis did fight in January against Hector Luis Garcia. Garcia forgo, decided to forgo the final fight, was supposed to fight. Rosito just up before this fight, said, no, I'll wait for the biggest fight of my life. Thank you very much.
Yeah, and you know, those right hands Garcia landed were good ones. And Davis now moving forward because he wants to try and take the play away.
Said no, I gotta throw my own punches. Make you feel uncomfortable.
They right hook to the body by Davis. Just past the midway point of the sixth round.
That's almost like Davis showing Garcia a way, showing him that you're not in the fight.
Garcia has been much more focused on landing that right hand in this round, even there he just missed one, but the ones he's landed have been good.
And there's a straight right down the middle for Garcia. A minute left here in the sixth, straight left for Davis. Davis trying to control the lead hand of Garcia. Oh, and just missed with that sweeping left hook.
Look at the stance from Davis, not committing when he doesn't need to.
45 seconds left. Garcia.
In these rounds with low output and not that many punches landed, the difference is which punches are more effective. And this round's a perfect example. You have to decide.
Let's not forget, Davis did say, I don't want to knock him out. I want to punish Ryan Garcia. I'm not saying that he's punishing him right now, but he is landing really good, significant punches.
That's what eventually the over Calvin Ford said. He doesn't train him to knock him out. He wants him to punish him, but Davis said he was going to stop him in the seventh or eighth. 10 seconds away from round number 7. As things heat up here between Davis and Garcia.
Very close round in round 6. Ryan Garcia had a very good moment in that round. Throws this right hand, Davis keeping his left hand very low, and that right hand got in. And there were a couple other right hands shortly after that Garcia was able to land as well. That one was a little glancing, but, and here, let's look at the same one as Garcia gets that right hand in. It wasn't the perfect right hand for him, but it was a nice punch, and it landed, and there were several of those during the course of the round.
The Charlo twins in attendance.
Left hook, so that wasn't a dynamite left hook, but it was one of the few left hooks he was able to get in.